Now that the Amazon S3 account is set up and running, we need to create a bucket for the content. Files are stored in these buckets much like a directory for your computer. You're limited to creating 100 buckets, but you can create any number of folders in a bucket to keep files separate. So from one bucket, we can serve all the content for our membership website. The bucket names are global in the Amazon system and must be unique in the system, one that's not used by another S3 user. To create a bucket, log into your Amazon S3 account and navigate to the AWS Management Console and select the S3 icon. At the top left is a panel with the Create Bucket button. Click that button and a pop-up will activate. Enter the bucket name. If that name is in use, then you'll get an error message and you'll need to enter another name. The region and the setup logging can be left at the default. Click the Create button. This is the bucket name that will be entered in the Amazon S3 bucket file name field for S2 member. Copy this bucket name. Now open another browser tab and log into your site and navigate to S2 member download options and click on the Amazon S3 CDN storage option bar to open the screen. Locate the Amazon S3 fields and copy the bucket name in the Amazon S3 file bucket name field. Now we need the security credentials for S2 member. Click on the Amazon S3 account tab, and at the top of the Amazon services screen is a drop-down. Click the security credentials link. This screen will have access to the identifiers that we need for configuring S2 member. Amazon S3 provides two parts to access keys. It provides the access key ID, and it also provides the secret access key. The ID is a public identifier, like a username, that specifies a particular Amazon S3 account. The secret key is the private identifier, like a password, that ensures you're the one making a request. It is important to note that the secret access key and all the access information are important and should be kept confidential to protect your account. If you lose this key, then you will need to generate a new ID that gives a new secret access key, which means the information must be updated in the S2 member screens to ensure proper access to the Amazon S3 files. You're only allowed two access keys at any one time. If you already have a key ID with the associated secret access key, then you can use that pair. If not, then click the Create New Access Key button. On the Success screen, click the Show Access Key link. Copy the access key ID, then switch browser tabs to the S2 member screen and copy the key to the Amazon access key field. Now switch the browser tab to the Amazon S3 account and copy the secret access key. Switch back to the S2 member screen and paste the secret key to the Amazon secret key. Now click the Save All Changes button at the bottom of the screen. Switch back to the Amazon S3 account and click the Download Key file and save this file in a very secure place. This is the ID and the secret key. If lost, you'll need to create another key and re-enter the new information. The Amazon S3 account setup is complete at this point. You can use only the S3 account to serve files. S2 member will look to the Amazon S3 bucket to find the file requested. You do not need the CloudFront component. But if you want better and more secure file transfer, then you want CloudFront, and for that, we need the keys. Click the CloudFront Key Pairs link. You're allowed two pairs for CloudFront also. If you have key pairs already, then you can use those. If not, click the Create New Key Pair. Key pairs have three components: the Access Key ID, and the Private Key File, and the Public Key File. S2 member needs the Access Key ID and the Private Key File to configure CloudFront. Click the Download Private Key File and save it to a secure place. It's also a good idea to download the public key file also. Now close the screen and copy the access key ID. If you've not already done so, open a new browser to your site, log in and navigate to S2 member's download options, and click the Amazon S3 CloudFront CDN storage option. Copy the access key ID in the Amazon CloudFront Key Pair ID field. Now locate the private key file you downloaded. This is the file that has a PK- at the beginning and open it in a text editor like Notepad or Notepad++. Do not open this file in a word processor. It will add unwanted code. Copy the entire file and make sure you capture all the characters, including the leading and ending dashes. Switch browser tabs to the S2 member screen and paste this file in the Amazon CloudFront private key field. And finally, make sure the Yes, automatically configure my Amazon CloudFront box is checked. This will trigger a pop-up. Click the OK button. Now click the Save All Changes button at the bottom of the screen. It could take about 30 minutes or so for S2 member to configure the CloudFront and for Amazon to deploy the distribution. You can see this process by clicking the Services link in your Amazon account and clicking the CloudFront link. You'll see two services deploying, one for RTMP and another for the web. And when they finish, the status will read deployed. You now have a cost-efficient, secure, reliable, high-performance system set up to stream videos and files to your customers.